Municipalities one by one are deciding to allow trick-or-treating to happen amid the COVID-19 pandemic. People in the community are ultimately supportive of that decision.
I think that it should be okay. Maybe just going door to door, everyone making sure that they wear a mask and gloves as the kids come up to the door.
I have three little great-granddaughters that are going to miss out on the trick-or-treating. And it's not going to be like when I was young, where my daughters were young. You know, it's so sad. They're missing out on everything.
Now, if you do plan on participating in trick-or-treating this year, whether it's handing out candy or taking the kids out for a few hours, there are ways to do it safely. First, use common sense to prevent the spread of germs. If you aren't feeling well, don't participate.
The most important thing is just if someone is sick, that they're not passing out candy or not going trick-or-treating.
If you are feeling well enough to participate, keep the safety precautions we've been practicing in mind.
Wearing a mask for both parties is very important, both the person handing out the candy and the trick-or-treater. And then just making it a quick drop, or maybe setting out candies on a table, spaced apart so that the trick-or-treater could just grab their own.
Paying attention to smaller details is another part of being safe when trick-or-treating.
Making sure that the packaging on the candy is totally intact, making sure things are prepackaged, you know, not taking anything homemade from anybody's house.
And when you're done, do a complete inspection of your kids' treats before enjoying them.
Check it all over, make sure everything, again, is totally prepackaged. When you're in doubt of a piece of candy or an item, then throw it away.
As your little ones head out this year for a night of tricks and treats, or if you're spreading the joy by handing out candy, keep these tips in mind for everyone's safety. Odessa Meredith, YourErie.com.